Howdy, I'm Chuck LeMahieu with Dragon Sailing, and today I'm going to show you how to use CorrosionX to waterproof your electronics, and also to use our new product, ReelX Marine Grease, to help seal up and keep lubricated all the key moving parts on your DF boat and seal up your internal electronics as well. And I'm going to do it right now. All right, let's talk about waterproofing your FlySky receiver, or any receiver with CorrosionX and ReelX. CorrosionX will actually protect your receiver and your electronics from water from actually shorting out from water. It's a dielectric, it's great. And what I do, you can either take your squeeze bottle and squeeze it directly on the motherboard, on the contacts. You don't want to over-apply it, but typically what I'll do, get this here and keep a nice clean surface. I'm going to apply it on the motherboard, make sure we get it all on there, get it on the lead ends. I'm going to take the motherboard actually out of here. I'm gonna get it all here. Make sure we got everything coated with CorrosionX, including the leads. So that we make sure all the electronic surfaces have a nice coat of CorrosionX on there. And what I like to do is typically when I do the receiver, I let it dry out a little bit. So I'll leave that and come back after probably 30 minutes or so after it's had a chance to dry. But you can also do it right here. And then what I like to do is seal up around the motherboard. And for that, I'll use the marine grease. So we'll stop water from getting in there once we've actually used the CorrosionX to waterproof it, because it can't hurt the electronics. So use a little bit of marine grease here, right around the ends of the tube, and right around the case, just to keep it sealed up. I'll snap it back together. Once it's dried out, you can also dry it off with your towel. Just keep a shop rag or shop towel handy. And you're not going to hurt the electronics by doing this. Take a little marine grease where the screw hole is going to. It's not going to hurt it. It is going to protect it, because ReelX also has CorrosionX in it. You don't want to use that to waterproof. You just want to use that to seal more. But you can reinsert the screws in there. Waterproofing your battery is pretty simple. There's not a lot of ways for water to get in here because it's heat sealed here. But the things you really want to make sure of when you're trying to get this waterproof with CorrosionX is to get a little right here on the lead ends and then down in here. In this case, we've already done our receiver as well. I like to put some on the balance plug because that can get corroded as well. Obviously, salt water is twice as corrosive. And with the new ReelX Marine Grease, I'll put a little dab right down here where the wire leads are, just to keep it a little sealed. You don't need a ton, just enough to keep that where it's soldered here and get that down in there. And that is all it takes to waterproof your battery. Let's take a look at how to waterproof your sail winch for your DF boat. This is the new DF sail winch. I've already removed the screws, which easily come out right here. There's two parts to the case. There's an upper part here and a lower part here. Once you undo the screws, lower part of the case just pops off. You can see what that looks like in there. So to waterproof my sail winch, again, you're gonna wanna take CorrosionX and put it on the primary circuit board here. Get in there real good. Now there's also another side to this, but since it seals up pretty good, I'm not gonna worry about that too much. We're just gonna basically get that. And then, pop the top off here. Take a little bit of marine grease on the bearing. It's on the top of the motor here. Get that lubricated. And then you can also take a little, you don't need a lot, just put some on the gearing. This ReelX is made, will not hurt plastic, and it'll just keep your gearing a little lubricated. You don't need a lot of it. I also like to take a little just around the seals here, so it'll keep, and once you, so it'll keep the case sealed. Again here, oops, you can tell on my neck that is. Now here, I'm gonna put a little right there, put a fine line along the edge of the case here, put some on the lead here. It's a little bit messy, if you take your time. Again, if you get a little on the motherboard, it's not going to stop the signal. What you're trying to do here is, once you get this thing put back together, you can pop the case back on. And you're going to get a little excess there. Just wipe it off. We kind of want that. Want to make sure it's got in there pretty good. Got on the horn pretty good. Then the case, you want this to go on that side. Obviously you want this to go on the side that has the wire lead. You just pop that on, put the screws back, and then I'll take a little marine grease here in the screw leads. Just a little, just a drop. So once it goes back down there, you're getting those sealed off pretty good as well. Nice thing about the ReelX marine grease is it stays a little longer than CorrosionX, and it's really meant to hold its viscosity a little longer and protect your electronics and your gears and whatever you're packing, and the grease actually. You don't want to use a grease to waterproof, even though it does have CorrosionX in it. You really want to use CorrosionX for your electronic leads, for your circuit boards, and use a marine grease for anything else that's external or has a moving part, like gearing, bearings, swivels, arms, that sort of thing. It's perfect for that. But you can see I've kind of got it's a little messy, but that's okay, because I've made sure we have waterproofed this servo as best we can. I'll be straight up front with you. There is no such thing as completely waterproofing anything, but this is about as good as it's gonna get for a sail winch. Got a little bit of a mess here, so let's just wipe it down good with this rag. And then on the lead, again, let's take a little CorrosionX here on there, wear parts here and on the ends. And that should get us done. there is my fully waterproofed new DS sail winch. Waterproofing your rudder servo. This is the Dragon Sailing DFMG GD1 upgraded rudder servo. It's got a really large motor, so waterproofing this one is actually a little challenging, but I'm going to show you how to do that right now. Again, we use our CorrosionX on the lead end. You want to get the exposed parts with CorrosionX, just regular CorrosionX. Wipe off the excess. Give yourself a nice towel or something to do all that with. I've already removed the machine screws from the bottom of the servo. And you can see that this is already glued. And we had them waterproof it a little bit, but it's no assurance that it's going to be 100%. Never, there is no such thing as 100% waterproof. What we can do is take our CorrosionX and put it on the circuit board, because you're not going to hurt it. CorrosionX is a dielectric. It's made to keep it waterproof. And you can see it's glued there. And additionally, while it's doing that, we're going to pop the top off here. See, it's got dual ball bearings. We're going to take our ReelX and get in the gearing here. Lube those up. This will also protect it if you sail in salt water a lot. This is another great thing to do. And then I put some around the seal of the case here. If you get excess, that's okay. Just wipe it off. It's not going to hurt yourself or the rudder. So we've got enough there. We're going to pop that back on. Now in this case, and this one with this motor sticking out, because it's got the beefiest, nastiest micro servo motor, more torque than anything I've seen, I'll put a little band of grease right here on either side. And then put a little bead around where the entrance gets in here, or the wire, and here. And you will, and again, you're gonna wanna get some in the screw holes here. You just take the case. You can tell which side it goes on because the wire obviously needs to seal up there. Pop that right back on. Got excess. You don't need to wipe it all off, but I don't like a messy rudder. We've done our job here. Just dab it off. Take a little bit of grease here on the screw ends, just a drop on each hole. And screws back in. If you're done with that, and you are done waterproofing your rudder servo. So now for a little bit of fun. Now that we've treated all our stuff with CorrosionX, let's see how well it protects. Here we have our treated receiver and our treated battery. We're going to plug in the battery. Immediately bound. We're going to plug in our sail winch. Plug in our rudder servo. also that we pre-treated. Got us a nice tub of water here. Tell you what, just so you can see everything's working. Oops. Our servo, sail winch, and let's just drop them in the water and see if that works. There's the sail winch working. You can see the rudder servo working. And the sail winch is fine. So, for those of you that doubt CorrosionX, and if you're not doing this to your boat, you are losing out. Little prevention goes a long way, folks.